Hi, this is Dr. Yang. This video is for healthcare professionals who are told that their hospital has run out of face shields and they're very worried for their own safety. So, you know, what can you do? The goal is to empower yourself. If the hospital isn't buying the equipment, you can buy very simple materials from an arts and crafts store like Michael's and make this yourself. Essentially, it is an acetate sheet, 9x12, a foam 1-inch foam cushion, and an elastic band. Everyone who's asking for them, you've warned them, you know that it's very easy to make. You look at it, you think, oh, I could make that. So that's what we're gonna do. If we're gonna wait for the factories, Ford, Toyota, Nike, to make them and deliver it, there's always a lead time. So what can you do today, right now? So let's say you're going, the number one thing you'll need is the graphics, acetate. This is called Duralar. This one comes in a pack of 25. I think it's less than $13. And that will make 25 shields. I have a roll of braided elastic, and you can make approximately 11 out of this one. This is 4.5 yards long. 4 yards will get you 10 elastic bands. Foam cushion. This is 1 inch thick. It comes in a giant roll at Michael's that is 2 feet wide by 6 feet long. If it were me and someone bought a giant roll of film, I would just cut a strip. It may not look as pretty as this one, but it'll do. Okay, so let's say it's cut. Next, we're gonna use plain scotch tape. Let's say you go to the nursing station, you grab a scotch tape, you're gonna grab a stapler. You know, we're talking, you know, emergent type or urgent situation. We're gonna roll the tape onto itself. I'm sure you've done this before. Stick it onto the foam and just line it up to the top edge, okay? We're essentially making an umbrella for our face, okay, a splash shield. Next, I'm gonna pull out about 14.5 inches of elastic and cut it. Again, these type of scissors at the nursing station, 14.5 inches. That's approximately a large head. That's comfortable for me. A medium is probably 14 and a small is maybe 13.5. Next, we're gonna line this up right here. What I'm gonna do to make it easier, I found that the stapling is a little bit tricky. So what you're gonna do to make it a little bit easier so you're not fumbling, you're gonna tape that on the front edge and then just line it up and tape it. We're gonna staple it so it's more secure. But this is just to make the stapling a little bit easier. Okay, you're gonna tape that on. Let's say if you can't find a stapler, this might have to do, okay? But the stapler is much more secure. So we're just gonna place the tape here. I'm actually pulling off the foam so I can show you guys. So I've taped the elastic on the edge, and that's really just so you can line up the staple. Actually, I'm gonna use the stapler. You recognize this. So the staple is gonna go on the outside of the shield, and then the elastic is on the bottom, and the acetate is on top. I'm gonna put two staples. So hopefully you can see there's two staples here. The tape holds it in place while you line it up. Otherwise, it's a little bit tricky to staple. You know, just line it up. I see they're doing 3D printed masks. If you've ever seen a 3D printer churn out its design, it can take literally like 10 minutes to up to half an hour to print out whatever it's printing. They also are using laser cutters to cut these shields, but if it's a rectangle, you don't need anything special. Literally, you can use a pair of scissors and then you're done and you can start taking care of patients. And you're on your next shift, you can make a fresh one and discard it depending on how confident you are about buying these supplies from your local shops. But other little details is you can maybe cut, round off the edges with your scissors so it looks more like the standard shield. When you're seeing patients with this shield, it looks pretty much like what you normally have. So they may not notice that it isn't the standard shield, and it'll protect your face from getting any mucus or body fluid or blood. The other reason for making it is if you have, let's say, an N95 mask, the two reasons why the masks become unusable is a direct spatter of blood or sputum or mucus directly on the shield and it's visibly contaminated, that you should throw out. The other reason is over time the filtration ability of the mask gets clogged with maybe microscopic or visible droplets, which you can't see but contains a little bit of mucus. Then over time it starts clogging the filter material of the N95, and it makes it very, very difficult for the user to breathe. And that would also be a reason for, it's filtering well, yet you can't breathe, then therefore you can't use it. Having a physical barrier like an umbrella will at least block that initial splash. At our hospital, the other thing they're doing is recommending that they use a procedural mask on top of their N95 in order to preserve the N95 so it can last longer. So one other thing I wanted to show, this is a way to make a procedural mask and maybe even save some of the other ones. So this is really instead of a splash shield or a face shield, this is your N95 shield. So what I have here is a piece of what it really is a cold pack sleeve. So at our office, we place a cold pack in and we give it to the patient. What I did is I modified this to become a makeshift face mask. And I call this design the Omega face shield, or the Omega face mask. So the reason is when it is folded up, if you look at it right here, it forms the Omega sign, okay? And the way it looks is like this. And then when you put it on, it covers the N95 mask. This is used in surgery as a drape material. In this case, this is a cold pack cover, and it is waterproof. So this way, you know, it doesn't soak through like a paper towel, and literally you can, if you have enough of these, you can discard them maybe between patients, or you know, you have a morning shift, you throw this one out because it's not even a real mask, and then make a second one for the afternoon. So now we're gonna make the Omega face mask. Okay, so the way that I designed it, I'm gonna give you a measurement. So this is approximately 7.5 inches long and about 5 inches wide, okay? To make it, you're gonna fold it in half lightly, and then from here, from the fold, you're gonna fold the front half to meet the middle, that slight middle fold, and then a second fold right here, okay? So this is the Omega face mask, okay? Once you do that, okay, this is the shape, you're gonna then fold this over to meet the middle. So you're gonna take this, then fold it over, and then take this other side and fold it over, okay? And then this kind of gives that Omega shape, okay? Next, we're gonna use a simple staple, again, using stationary supplies. And right where, I'm gonna block my face, right where the seam is, we're gonna place a staple from front where the seam is to back, okay? You want the sharp side of the staple facing the outside of your mask, okay? So you don't get scratched by the staple, okay? So I just placed the staple right here. I'm gonna finish the Omega fold right down the other side, okay? Like this. We're gonna staple the open end with the staples coming in this way to the open end. Okay, so next, what you'll need is paper clips and a stationary rubber band, or some kind of rubber band. These are the big loop kind that sometimes they'll wrap like 8.5 by 11 documents, like in folders. So these are pretty common for the secretaries. If it's any smaller, you can't really wrap a stack of documents. A standard paper clip, and then here we go. So we have our Omega shield. We're gonna place the paper clip, and this is just to cover the N95. It's literally a N95 shield, okay? So that on top, underneath the face shield. We're gonna slide this down, okay? Sorry. You're gonna slide the paper clip down. Notice the edge of the big loop here is on top. You're gonna, to make it more secure, you're gonna pull this flap and then tuck it so you only see half of it, okay? Same thing on this side. We're gonna slide this over the top, okay, and then push it down, okay. You'll see the big loop, we're gonna pull one side of the flap, tuck it underneath, you only see half of it, okay. We're almost done. I'm gonna pull this up a little closer so you can see me. I'll sit a little closer. Just pull the Omega shield over your ears, like this, loop it on. You'll be wearing your N95 ready, and just pull it up like this. Okay, it creates a little tent in the center. There's some leakage, but the main thing is we're using this as another shield. With your face shield, then you have a secondary shield. If there's an aerosol, most of it hits the shield, which you can wipe off. Let's say some Venturi effect comes around the shield, you have a second shield to catch any light droplets. And then, because it's so simple to make, you can discard them more frequently. Or in another situation, let's say there's no acetate shields in the meantime. You're gonna have to wait until an overnight delivery for the next day, but they only gave you one N95 mask for the day or week. Then how are you gonna protect that shield? So you potentially you can put on your N95, place the second one on top, and just keep it as clean as you can. So I think that's all I have to say for the frontline healthcare workers. I hope you guys can stay safe. We appreciate everything you're doing. I'm doing everything I can. You know, just looking at the general problem and looking for this, whatever solutions I can do as quickly as I can. So far with these face shields, The first batch I made 48 out of a roll of 40-inch acetate that was, I think, 12 feet long, 48 of them. Then I made another 66 using these, and then I ran out of foam. So I had two more for demonstration purposes. And I've been working on the Omega mask. My heart is with you guys and wherever you are. This is kind of a MacGyver type thing, but I'm just imagining if I'm in your situation, I'm at the hospital already and they literally tell you, sorry, we don't have PPE for you or one particular piece. This is, I think the face shield is actually really important. N95s you can't make, so all we can do is conserve, but if we can make that N95 last longer just with an umbrella on top of it, this is low tech. If you don't have time to make it, or your Michaels or your art supply store is not available, maybe you can ask your family member in a state where maybe it's not locked down yet, or they can deliver it and they can make it at home while they're just sheltering in, and then send it to it as quickly as possible. But as you can see, this is relatively easy. The other thing I was thinking of was that, sorry to make this so long, the idea of making your own shields actually came from a news article maybe 2.5 weeks ago, from Seattle, where the hospital staff themselves, they were using vinyl sheets, foam, and elastic. It wasn't even braided elastic. It looked like just elastic cords, and fashioning it. And they they're talking about their desperation, that was literally like almost 2 weeks ago. They're already doing this. So that inspired me to try to do something, and just use something where, when the supply chain is completely overwhelmed and everyone is drowning and everyone is grabbing for the same stuff and just sitting there and waiting, you have to look for another solution. You have to think outside the box and think, okay, you have a face shield. What are the things that people are not looking for? Okay, so this, this may start becoming in more short supply once that we start doing this. In other countries where they don't even have art supplies like this, they're using a 2-liter Coke bottles, and cutting off the bottom and then, opening it up and just using that, that square piece in the middle as a face shield. I hope it doesn't come to that, but, let's do what we can and be safe. That's it for this video. Sorry. Bye.